Okay, so we're doing three birds with one stone day today. We had to go out the Sarnia direction, so I delivered some parts to a fellow VW enthusiast. And then I went and we cleaned up a big property, all the gravel and everything. And then on the way back here now, we're just cleaning up this. Look, there's a bathtub there. That's cool. Did something there. Now we're just picking up an F-150. Now I don't know how complete it is here, but it looks pretty rough. looks like we're gonna have to give her. Hey, it's a John Deere. It's gonna match yours, Rambo. We're gonna have to give her a tug. We'll give her a tug and then hook on her straight. Yeah. Well, I can fix your truck up there, Rambo. Your transmission slipping or something like that now?
Yep.
Yeah. So. Alright. Okay, so.
I don't even know if I have keys for the thing. The ownership's supposed to be with it, but a lot of times they say that, but then it's not even there, so I don't know. Somebody always takes the ownership out of it, and then when you go to need it, you don't have it. See what happens here. Door won't even open. I'm a hunk of junk. Well, at least I have keys. Well, that's a plus. Alright. That's good. So let's hook on her here and be on our way again.
Yep, so that's right. Of course, no ownership, but at least they put the keys in it. But maybe that's until I pay for them. He's at work today, so I don't know. We'll see what happens. He was amazed at my price, what I could get the Volkswagen VW exhaust for, because here in Canada, it's just atrocious, the amount that they want to charge you to get like apples to apples. It's just so stupid, the price difference. I think it was $600 for the one part, and in the States it was $150, so it's just ridiculous. But anyways, he's in the exhaust business, and I already bought the cats off this one. We checked that out, and this truck is pretty beat up, like one gas tank strap holding it on. It's pretty well ready for scrap. But, 4.2 liters, so Rambo can't use any of the parts off of it, unfortunately, for his John Deere truck. But anyways, now we better get back and save the day at the homestead.
Uh-oh, trying to get the 46 Dodge to run. Oh, looks like it's going to be a task. I didn't think that the running boards were included in this truck, but they're inside. So, take a look at this. It's a little bit of roughness here. It looks like it's seen some better days. Anyways, this is the battery we stole from Caddy. So, we had it out anyways to give it a full good charge, like overnight. So, yeah, it's not going to work for this one, but we're running wondering if we can get used jumper cables from here to there, and then we may have to use the booster pack in order to keep it going. So we'll see if that will work. Right now, Pants is cleaning all the crud around the spark plugs, and we're gonna see if we can put some diesel in there and see if we can free up any stuck rings or anything of that sort. We just put another spark plug boot, spark plug on the one. So should be able to get up and turning over, provided we have enough battery and nothing's seized. Okay, all the plugs are have been put, a little bit of diesel put in it. We put the wires on it. Yeah, keep working it. Yeah, that pushes your starter to engage it. This is your clutch. You get your foot off the clutch and just see if we can get that, just the main starter on. Yeah. looks like it's gonna be a little prick. We need a big pry bar there. So yeah, anyways, I got a little jerry can of gas to see if we can get this to go. Got the battery all hooked up here.
Holy cow.
Yeah, I'll just see if
I'm
we can.
Right on the button and nothing.
Nothing's happening.
Button's even seized.
Probably might have to jump the. Oh, the engine oil was down about a liter and a half, so we got that in there. Yeah, we probably might have to get a hunk of wire and just jump it from one to the other and see. Not even going. Yeah, crap, man. Yeah, so basically, is it this? Is that the solenoid wire?
We're all going in the same spot.
Well,